It's Mailbag Monday. Let the opening commence. This is Trip Hammer Robust Porter from Blind Man Brewing in Lacombe, Alberta. Kind of neat. The can has some patent type drawings of a mechanical trip hammer on it, and a bit of a story of the trip hammer being the original blacksmith's power hammer. Nice and roasty and malty, just the way I like it. So the first thing in is data lines. Let's see what this is. Oh, it's a USB cable. What variety? That looks like USB-C. Oh, wow. This doesn't feel like just your typical cloth weave on here. That feels a little bit more for... Oh, maybe it's just a rigid plastic. Okay, this looks like a fairly long one, too. Does it say on there, or do I have to... Oh, it says 2 meters. Okay. That's going to be good for charging my phone. Yeah, right now the cable that I've got for charging my phone on my bedside table is just about that much too short, and the phone keeps ending up on the floor every time anything moves. So hopefully having a 2 meter cable will fix that problem for me. Four Samsung Note 9 S9 Plus braided USB Type-C charging data sync charger cable. This one, currently it's going for $3.76 Canadian. It was $3.53 when I bought it. I think the American price didn't change, just the dollar did. I got this from To The Better, who has currently got shipping charges on it. But of course, back when I bought it, it didn't have, it was a free shipping. But they seem to have changed it, as often happens. And these are available in a bunch of different colors. And it's a USB-C cable, yet they've got all these USB-C devices to choose from. And it's all the same cable. They claim it's extra durable and resistant to bending damage. I guess we'll see eventually. Nylon over TPE, 21 gauge power, 28 gauge signal. They claim it can handle 2 amps. Okay.
We'll get out my trusty little USB load here, which I think has, yes, it does have a USB-C input. Okay. There's that. And I've got my USB output on my little power supply here, set to 5 volts, 2.5 amp current limit, which should be plenty. So let's see what happens. Okay, there's half an amp, 2.2 watts, 4.5 volts. That sucks. But I guess that's those 20-some gauge wires. Let's go up to an amp. There we go. What's it say over in the power supply? Drag that in a little bit further here. So there is actually an amp being drawn out of the power supply. This thing's drawing an amp, so that's reasonable. That's still at basically 5 volts. 4.3 watts, 4.2 volts. That sucks. Let's see what happens when we get up to... There's 1.5 amps. Yeah, this guy agrees. 4 volts. Wow. That just doesn't... there's a lot of loss in that cable. That's not great. Let's pull it right up to the full 2 amps that it said it can handle. 2 amps. Yep, 2 amps coming out of the power supply. That's drawn down to 3.9 volts. Seriously? Wow. That's way below spec. I'm hoping that with quick charge, which I don't have the technology to test right here on the bench, but with quick charge, that should give me a higher voltage, which will be lower I squared R losses. I would hope. Not as impressed as I was hoping to be with this cable. Okay, let's see what's in the big bag here. It says measuring cups, which I think it might actually be. Yes, it is a bunch of little, kind of like medicine measuring cups. get one of these guys out of here. Yeah, so these are graduated measuring cups, 60 milliliter or 2 ounces at the top of them. Down to 5 milliliters or say what, 1/8 of an ounce. And the reason I got these was, do you recall when I was doing the epoxy mixing for, oops, let's turn that on, for making this little circuit board into a coaster? Oh, I used medicine mixing cups, but I realized I only had like one or two left, and those were left over from the kids' medicines when they were kids, when they were really young. So I decided to go on eBay and get myself some more just in case I found the need to mix up some more epoxy. It would also be good for, I guess, mixing paints and stuff. But the epoxy was mostly why I got these. 10 pieces, 60 milliliter medicine measuring measure cups, plastic transparent liquid scale cup. I got these for, well, it was a little bit cheaper when I bought them. Currently they're selling for $4.78 for 10. I bought two packages, so 20, and I paid $7.19 Canadian for them at the time. Got this from wonderfulparthome_US with free shipping. However, at the moment, they're not selling anything at all. So, as usual, I will link you to a search term that will find you something similar. Not too much to say about them down here in the description. About 4.9 centimeters tall. Dimensions, yeah, 60 milliliters. Non-sterile, latex-free, high-quality PP. Polypropylene, I guess. Transparent, accurate. Yeah, used for measuring small amounts of liquid, such as mixing epoxy, which was my use case. These mailbags are nothing if not varied. What is this one? Stepper motor drivers. Oh, interesting. Seems like something that I probably would have ordered. Wonder which kind this is, because I have ordered a few different kinds. Looks like it's a package of 5 of them. They tend to come in packages of 5 because if you're doing a DIY 3D printer or CNC machine, you typically use them in groups of 5s. And I think these are the same as the ones that I started off with in my my SkyCam project, based on the HR4988. As we've seen before, direction step, sleep and reset, micro stepping, an enable pin, ground and voltage for the control side, ground and voltage for the motor side, and then the 4 motor coil wires. I'm guessing I ordered these back when I started that, can I actually make a homemade SkyCam project, because I was just assuming that I was going to burn some out. Plus, I didn't know at the time that Dan was going to send me this whole box of stepper motors, to play with as well. So now I've got lots of drivers for all of that, which is really cool. Big Tree 4988 stepper motor driver Reprap, a 4988 driver Stepstick 2 amp with heat sink. I got the 5 pieces green. I'm not sure what the difference between the red and the green ones are, except for the color of the board. Oh, except the red ones are a bit more expensive. Back when I ordered them, I paid $5.74 with free shipping for these, and I got them from BQ, I think that's pronounced. They tend to sell a lot of 3D printer parts and supplies for homemade CNC and 3D printers and stuff like that. Down in the description, they've got a quick connection guide, which is correct based on my memory of using these previously. Over temperature thermal shutdown, under voltage lockout, overcurrent or current protections, short protections, all kinds of good things. And you can set the maximum current. And yeah, the micro-stepping settings, just hardware jumperable too. So there is the red one and the green one. What's the difference? I don't know. They look pretty much identical to me. I got the green one just because it was a couple of cents cheaper. Okay, let's bounce back to this big one. It says it's a mouse pad. Ah, what have I done? It is a cheap mouse pad. A very cheap mouse pad with a little skishy armrest on it. So how big is this guy here? Where's my... There we go. So this looks like it's about 18 centimeters wide by 22 or 23 that way. The thickness of the pad's about 1 centimeter, give or take. I don't mind. Yeah, that's fairly squishy. I don't mind. I kind of like actually having the wrist rest. My editing computer upstairs has one like that, but I don't have a mouse pad down here in the shop, so that's what this is for. Yeah, that does the business. The mouse sits on there. My wrist is comfortable on there. Yeah, that's reasonable. Okay, this one took some searching because I ordered it way back in April, and as you can see, I paid $1.64 for it from this guy, Heiz Tech, who, like so many of these, has disappeared off eBay. Here's a search term that finds a bunch of them, and that's what's going to be linked below. And there's nothing super special about it. It's just a mouse pad. And the last thing is, it says 320 pieces laptop screws. Did I order a whole bunch of screws? It's got some weight to it. Yeah, that looks like screws. So a whole assortment of, I'm assuming these are like M2 and M3 and smaller sizes like that that are really hard to find for anything less than an exorbitant price in Canada. These are looking like they're mostly M2s, I think, of various lengths. That looks about 4 or 5 millimeters. That looks like a full centimeter. And we have black ones, and we have with flat tops, we have silver colored ones. Yeah, so there's the complete assortment. 320 pieces M2/M2.5/M3 machine screws set for laptop, hard disk, keyboard, phone, PC, DIY. I ordered this from CE10WY, who doesn't sell this anymore, and the listing has fallen off the edge of the earth due to it being so long ago when I ordered these. This guy's got a bunch of different screws available, but not this particular set. So as always, I will link you to the search, and we'll just take a quick look at somebody else who does have this in stock right now. So there is all the different sizes and lengths and stuff. I don't actually see any M3 in. Oh, there's M3 by 3. Okay, that's the only M3s in there. No wonder I couldn't see them, and they're tiny. So there are longer M2.5s and M2s. There's the ones that I measured right there. And there's the actual listing, 16 different types of 20 pieces each for the total of 320. So there we go. This is just stock. As I said earlier, metric screws are really hard to find around here unless you go to an expensive specialty place. And the standard hardware stores, even in those small drawers that they have in the hardware store aisle, they barely have any metric screws, and they are ridiculously expensive here for some reason. I guess it's considered an imported specialty item.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite varied, mostly restocking and utilitarian stuff, but still interesting nonetheless, I think. So, shipping times. The stepper drivers took 35 days. This USB-C cable took 52 days. Not too impressed with the cable, though, but it'll do the job. The 320 screw assortment took 143 days, which is why I couldn't find the listing. The mouse pad took 194 days, also why I couldn't find the listing. And these mixing measuring cups took 93 days. Yeah, this disappointing thing. I guess it'll do for a slow trickle charge, but I'm still kind of keeping my eyes out. The best cable charging cables that I've got so far from anywhere are these Anchor, what do they call them? They call them Powerline, I think, that I got in USB, was it micro? Yeah. Unfortunately, I got those just before two or three of us in the household switched over to phones that use USB-C. So I'm slowly getting USB-C. In the meantime, I'm running these little adapters on these micros to get up to the USB-C. It's not ideal, but it does the job. But I think I will try and use this one on my bedside table just to, it'll trickle charge me overnight well enough, I think. Anyway, thanks for watching and for sticking around to the end here. I appreciate that. Thanks as always to my Patreon supporters.
for helping me pay for this stuff and buying me a beer. I do appreciate it, guys. And I noticed I got a couple of new ones in October and one already in November. So cheers to you guys. And yeah, thanks for watching. Comments and questions down below. I'll talk to you later.